What's up, Madden 16 fans? My name is Cody, and today I want to welcome you to our YouTube channel. Today what we're going to try to do is we're going to try to give you some tips and strategies as to how to be successful in Madden Online Salary Cap Ranked. That's the game mode we're playing today. I've really enjoyed this game mode. It's basically rejuvenated me at this point in the Madden season. I'm so thrilled to be able to share with you guys this gameplay. And we're going to get started here. So basically, guys, where we left off in the last video is that we were talking about all the different strategies for your lineup, all the different things that you can do. And in today's video, we're going to pick right up there, continuing on, and we're going to be focusing today on my quarterback. So I'm using this Ryan Mallett card. And the thing about Ryan Mallett, guys, is that he's got pretty good throwing stats for a 26 cap value quarterback. And the more I play salary cap, the more I recognize that as long as you set your feet up, you're normally going to be okay throwing the football. The problem is that when people send pressure, they come in and you are about to get hit, and right then you throw the ball. I notice there's a lot of drop off in accuracy during those times. And I also notice there's a lot of drop off in accuracy when you try to use high pass leads or you try to use low pass leads. Okay, so those are two things that I am really fond of using, but just understand that those are some of the times where you're going to be getting overthrows in this game. All right, so salary cap is a different beast for sure. And one of the things you see me doing is, I'm a big fan of the Gun Bunch. I've been a big fan of the Gun Bunch for a very long time. And I'm trying out some new strategies with my tight ends. I'm using the Tony Gonzalez, because for the Gun Bunch, you have to have a tight end, because in salary cap, you can't substitute a wide receiver for tight end, unfortunately. So I'm using the Signature Series Tony Gonzalez card, and trying to use his 99 route running to my advantage. I've also got the Antonio Brown. And man, that's like the third ball that he has dropped for me. Guys, Antonio Brown is 98 catching traffic. So I don't know why he is dropping so many balls, but he literally drops everything for me. I don't know what it is. But anyway. So that was good user defense right there. I didn't have an alternative receiver. All right, so in this situation, when you're playing salary cap, I mean, I don't know. Some people would say to punt here. The more I play Madden, the more I don't like to punt, just because of the timing. I don't know what are we doing? That's so stupid. I was playmakering and nobody was doing anything. Gosh dang it, that really... we have had some really bad first drives. Alright, so defensively though, I'm still trying out this theory with my corners. We're going with very good, spectacular catch corners. And also they have 95 or higher man coverage. And the reason that the threshold for me was 95 is because of the route running, what happens when you have receivers who have 99, or excuse me, who have 96 or above route running. It goes with the aggressive catch, so let's see how we do. And he catches it. Dang it. Well, that was fun while it lasted. Go up against Herman Moore, I guess, and you just get Moss. Well, that's one catch. I mean, that's one catch, so we can't get too mad just yet. He gets that all game. And see, I get mossed when I have 99 zone. I get mossed when I have 98 zone. So, I don't know, guys. We talking single one-on-one coverage, I mean. I guess it's just that nature, man. Anybody can get beat. Offensively, that was a terrible first possession. Started it just fine, but then we had a drop, and anyway. This Christian Thompson is a beast, guys. He is a beast. I think he's gonna get this one. Yeah, that's another kick return for him, guys. And I'm telling you, he's a monster of a kick returner. He's a monster of a halfback to have. Guys, I would highly recommend getting this Christian Thompson. It's just the base. It's just the basic Christian Thompson. I think he's a bronze card. But he's only like 16 cap value. And I was using the Michael James, and he was just as good. I mean, the Michael James honestly was probably a little bit better than Christian Thompson. But Chris Thompson was cheaper for the salary cap. Michael James cost 20 cap value, and Chris Thompson only cost 16. So that was really the deciding factor. Because I only use him in very select situations. There's really only two things I need him for. I need him for kick returns, and I need him for like halfback tosses. That's really pretty much it. That's all that I ever really do with that player on my team. So, and Christian Thompson does exactly what I need him to do. There's some pressure. And then the Stanley Havili does pretty good for me because what he brings to the table is he's able to get open against linebackers because he's got, I think it's 85, I don't know, 80 something. It's like mid 80s route running. But he's for the cap value because he's only 16 cap value. So there, Dominique Rodgers-Camara gets the interception. And that's important. And I really do. I think it's spectacular catch, guys. I mean, obviously you have to have some zone coverage because I did try just spec catch in the beginning of the year. You have to have some zone coverage and speed and all of those things. But I think one of the main deciding factors is your spectacular catch rating. And as we can see right there, Dominique Rodgers-Camara, he's got 92 zone coverage, but he's got like 98, or I mean, he's got a very high spectacular catch rating. And if we're not careful, this guy's going to run man-to-man on us all game. Come on. 1 for 6. Come on, Ryan Mallett. Have a feeling this guy is going to be man-to-man all game long. Till I show him that I can beat it. Check down to Tony Gonzalez here. We only got it 2 yards. So we're in a fourth down situation again. Offense has not looked very good so far. Let's see if we can't get these crossers. Oh my gosh. That's so bad. I have the plays to beat man to man, and I just, for whatever reason, I get stubborn and I don't want to run my man beaters. Gosh dang it. So defense has got to get at it again. There's Aaron Lynch. Looks like this guy's going to run with the Lamar Miller. That's a good running back. I mean, if you run the ball a lot, guys, I just don't run the ball very much. I mean, I don't really run much else other than fullback dive and halfback toss. That's occasionally I'll run an inside zone, but that's rare. I mean, there's my guy Lonnie Ballantyne. Defense steps up again. So, he's been running that corner strike play most of the first half, and there I was able to jump on him. And let's see if the freaking offense can get going because we have not played well at all to start this game off. Oh my God! Come on, Ryan Mallett. Dang it, I can't believe this is probably the worst I've ever played on offense right now. Check down. Oh boy. 3 of 9. I tell you what, guys, 2 men is hard to beat. I mean it, especially when you throw in a user player who's making good adjustments. If someone, that's why Sirius Moe, A lot of people don't give Sirius Smith the credit he deserves. That's why he won, guys. That's why he won that Madden Challenge. He made the key adjustments when he needed to make them. My boy Tyler Boyd making catches. But, I mean, you guys are going to be able to see situations that are going to arise in this game. You know, a lot of what he's going to try to do to take away my offense is he's going to run two men under and he's going to throw flat zones and buzz zones on the outside. And that's going to be it. And you have to be patient. The biggest thing when facing man-to-man is you have to be patient. You have to remember that he's probably, if he's running two men under, normally there's not a whole lot of pressure coming your way. And, you know, that reality, you know, that means something. There's my boy Tyler Boyd going up making a play. I'm starting to get into a little bit of a rhythm here. I'm expecting him to probably change it up any moment. So what I want to do is I want to be ready for that when it comes. We're going to swing Brown out here. And there's my boy Christian Thompson at least getting his hands on the ball because we made a bad read. Normally I run Z-spot, but I've been having some trouble with Z-spot lately. It hasn't been doing everything that I've wanted it to do. But part of that's my own fault. There's going to be a dot. And there's Z-spot, and there's the man beater. The reason that Z-spot works so well, let me explain, is that basically the motion is the same exact motion as another play that we run a lot, the play we run, the divide play. And if we establish the divide out route, he knows that that motion is for that divide out route. Well, when you're able to run a route where he's going to have to user guard it on the backside with the, on the right side of the field, it begins to be problems because now we're attacking him. We got that PA post play, which we can attack him on the outside on the right. We got the Z spot, which we can attack him on the middle. And then we have the divide play, which we can attack him on the far outside to the left. And that's the reason, like right there, he went out there to user control that, you know, that motioned out route. And we were able to come back around, hit him with the Z spot route, end up going up by one score, and the offense, you know, doesn't look as bad as it was looking. Oh, defense just gave up another big play. And inside zone, man. I hate inside zone this year because I can't run it as good as everybody else can. Dang it. Well, that's okay. We got 2 minutes. Come out, score. Go into half. I think we had the ball first, didn't we? Ah, a little bit late on my juke move there. But yeah, I mean, offensively, and this is the thing, guys. I mean, I've had a lot of success this season with using like Stanley Havili instead of maybe like somebody else of the same caliber. Crossing pattern underneath. Yeah, man, they just freaking stick to him like glue this year in man-to-man. Crap. Havili's not supposed to be on that route. And see, there we... Now, and see, because of Z-spot, right, that opens up that out route now. And it's a chess game. If he's going to stay in man-to-man, you know, we're going to be able to beat man. Man, thought Boyd was open. But, I mean, and he's going to probably stay in man. He's going to make adjustments here, there, everywhere, but he's going to stay in man for the majority of this game. You can already tell that's his game plan. So what we're going to look to do, continue to kind of stay small. Oh, we throw a pick. Well, that's not staying too small, is it? Dang it. Two men under, man. Gosh, I hate that defense so much. Thought I had a step on him. I was going to be able to throw it over him. We'll come back with him. Two men of our own. Go get him. Pretty good coverage. Pretty good coverage. And my that's my boy, William Jackson III. He was covering... Dang it, I can't see who he's covering. Gosh dang it. Right there, we got caught on our defensive end. I couldn't tell who he's covering, though. Problem with man-to-man this year, guys, is pretty much the fact that if they drop underneath zones, there's not a whole lot we can do. Gosh dang it. My boy Stanley Havili making a big time catch in a big time situation. So right there what happened was offensively I basically got caught in a play I didn't want to be in, and my guy Havili had to make that play, and he did. There's that playmaker curl. Coming up big for us. Stupid. We didn't stop the clock. Dang it. All right, here we're going to try hit PA post with that slot hitch. And Boyd makes another great catch for us on the outside. Now we have KC Divide loaded up. We dot him up with Brown, and now we're in a red zone situation. So it's not been a smooth game by any stretch of the means offensively, but somehow we're in position to go up by two scores going into halftime. Here's Christian Thompson. I'm going to have to check down to him. A little halfback zone. We'll tick that clock a little bit, make him force him to use a timeout. I'm assuming what he'll do is he'll run commit. You know, I mean, that's his strategy for goal line defense this season so far. Let's see what we can do. Yeah, well, that was pretty good on his part. And make him take that timeout. We're going to make him take that timeout, guys. He thinks that he's okay. Flip the play here. We want to run this pitch. And we'll take a timeout. We left ourselves enough time to take one timeout. Main thing was my defense has been playing good, but it hasn't been playing great. We've given up two big plays. I wanted to basically make sure that I go into halftime at least up a field goal. He got his goal line stop, but we got our field goal. We're out at half, and we're just fine. I mean, we're up one possession. Obviously, you want to make it two there, but sometimes it's not in the cards. You got to be okay with taking your three in games like this. Obviously, this guy knows what he's doing. You know, he's running his two-man. He's adjusting offensively. There's Nate Askew making a freaking great play on the special teams. And you guys, as I was saying, guys, I mean, little things. It's the little things in a game of Madden that make it so much, so hard to... When you overlook little things like your special teams, or you overlook little things like your... like your special teams or your field goal, decision making, your goal line and all that stuff, when you overlook stuff like that, then what ends up happening is it leaves the door open for other things to pop off, i.e. what just happened with the kickoff. That's the first hit stick fumble I think I've gotten on a kickoff all year. But I put myself in that situation because I practiced that over and over and over again. Okay? And again, that's why you got to play all facets of the game. You got to play special teams. You got to play, certain defenses in certain situations. So right here, I got to make sure that he doesn't get a big play. So my main thing right now is to go coverage two man. And there Herman Moore dots us up again. So the two passes he's completed have been, Herman Moore prayers, and that's been it. See if we can get some pressure in him. Make that hard. My boy Paia gets the pick, and the defense is playing a heck of a ball game. Now, immediately, what I'm thinking here is you want to go into clock mode if you're trying to win the game because you've got a two possession lead. Now, if I go down and get a. Now, what you got to think about right now is the score. So we're up 27 to 14. If I go get a field goal, that's going to put me up 16 points. It is very hard to come back from 16 points down in a 4 minute, quarters, session. But we're going to dot him over the middle. My boy Boyd on the Z spot route is toasting Antonio Cromartie because of that route running. It's because he's got that 98 route running above that threshold of 96. All right, so right here, this situation, we're going to try and take advantage of the fact that he's probably going to over pursue that middle. Luckily, we got rid of the ball. So there, he does a pretty good job there. We haven't been able to spring our we haven't been able to spring some of our man reads off of the jam because he's doing a good job with the press coverage. So right here, we're going to try and do it a little bit of a different way. Leaves him wide open. Yep. So the thing is, with all the underneath crossers, the reason we what we did right there was we went with straight man, straight unbumpable reads. We got him to go, and we got him to basically user defend the underneath drags, and it left the Z spot open because we had ran PA post over and over and over again. This time we run it from Z spot, and we have that deep post coming in behind it. And we end up getting, we end up getting a score there. So, anyways, guys, that's gonna wrap up today's video. I just wanted to share that with you, show you what I'm doing so far. I think we just leveled up or whatever. But anyways, guys, wanted to share this.